Drew and T are driving over 5 hours away towards the south coast.
They were a big company in the songwriting world. You know, it was a big outfit doing international and national stuff.
Sign bonanza then.
Stacks of old letters, stacks of neons, old signboards, pub signs. That's what we're after.
Brilliant. Full van.
The business is based in Portsmouth. Perched on England's south coast, the city is best known for its maritime connections. Just over a mile from the dockyards is Eberhardt Signs Limited. Owner John Eberhardt is the second generation to work at the business, which was started by his father in 1956. John is now retiring and closing down the company. He's hoping to find good homes for all his remaining stock, which has been handcrafted using techniques passed down through the family.
Basically, my father's grandfather was a master glassblower in Germany, and they were involved at Crystal Palace making the first light bulb. So that was his introduction to glassblowing. There's not many old companies like us that did everything in-house predominantly, and therefore it's sort of the end of the line for this type of signage, really.
Hi there, Drew.
How are you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Drew,
hi,
nice thanks. To meet you.
I am T. John. How are you doing?
Hi there. Nice cool. to meet you.
Thanks for having us. Shall we go and have a look?
Enjoy. After you.
Thanks.
Well, I see. Okay.
So what's the deal here? You're closing down, I believe.
Yes, it's all closing down and I'm retiring. That's the plan.
Yeah.
So everything's got to go.
Well, signwriting is something I know a bit about. I was brought up the son of a signwriter.
All right.
And he worked from home, so it was always there was always people knocking on the door at 9 o'clock on a Sunday night wanting the telephone number changed for Monday morning, which he'd do.
Expectations are high today. It's a large old factory. I know that signage, there's a high changeover rate of signage. And with my father's business, the signs tended to come off the wall and get chucked in a corner and forgot about for years and years and years. I'm hoping the same's happened here.
The workshop has been sorted and arranged, ready for the items to be sold off.
It's not going to take long to look around this lot, is it?
It's very neat.
Very organised. So everything's for sale?
Everything.
Everything. Well, there you go. First thing through the door, and I'd like to buy that, if possible.
First thing we see, right in front of me, ladies' cloakroom illuminated hanging sign from a theatre. Great little item, had lots of them in the past. This is really nice and small, so you can put it in your bathroom at home, and we'll fix the lights up, and it's not been polished. It's got everything going for it.
This illuminated cloakroom sign dates from the 1950s. Once rewired, it could be worth around £200.
What would you want for that?
We'll start at 500, shall we?
It's been lovely meeting you. No, I think we're a zero off. No, roughly what? Go on, what do you want?
I think about £80.
£80. Let's not mess about. I'll take that for £80.
You're welcome.
There you go. Right, OK, that's done.
First buy, get it out of the way, 80 quid, we'll take it. Restoration on this is minimal. We're going to pick some of the old paint off, give it a clean, just to the glass, dust the light assembly at the top, rewire, new chains and ceiling hook. That's it.
You've got some stands as well. But these are good. These are all phosphor bronze ones, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. I like the font. Very nice. T?
E. It's got my name written all
look
over it.
Look at that. You can have that, T.
Can I?
Yeah.
You haven't bought it yet.
No. These are lovely. I've got a set of these up in my house.
Mm-hmm. In your house?
In my house, yeah.
It's true, there.
Yeah, I was just doing this, just doing exactly that there. So now I could have Drew Pritchard.
Letters like these I've been selling for as long as I can remember. They are wildly available, but not in quantities like this. This is quite a good find. People really like them, and we have to have something cheaper on the floor that they can buy. And it keeps people coming back. And then when you can buy quantity like this, it really does help.
These letters would have been used as signage for shops and businesses, and are now popular with interior designers. The 38 phosphor bronze letters date from the 1920s and 30s and could be worth around £40 each. The 14 enamel ones are from the late 19th century and could be worth around £65 each.
So it really is just what you want for it, really.
I would think, to be realistic, each letter is worth in the region of £40.
Right.
So how many are there?
Retail. Or now?
Well, I'd like it to be now.
I bet you would. These ones, what sort of price on those?
These are probably more like sort of £6, £7 a letter.
OK. Right, well, I'll take all of those and all of those at six. Mm-hmm. That's fine. And these... Go on, hit me with a figure, then.
400.
Yeah.
They're yours.
Bronze and enamelled letters over there. We're doing a bulk purchase at £400, which is just over £30 each. These ones at £6 each, great. That we'll buy these all day long.
Two deals done, and John now wants Drew to check out the other end of this massive former workshop.
That's quite nice, isn't it?
I know. I'll tell you what you're always claiming.
What? What are you doing?
Sunshine out your hair.
It does.
Despite the vast number of signs on offer, it's something different that catches Drew's eye.
Where do you get these from, then? Unusual things to have in a sign-writing firm.
Well, actually, this is from my father's nautical collection.
I've had a couple of pairs of these before. One was fully polished, and one was in a similar condition to this, and a little bit larger, and I stupidly sold them. I sold them the same day I bought them, which you should never, ever do. So to find another pair of these in the original paint, unpolished, with all the parts on the factory tripod is quite a find.
These German flak binoculars and tripod are from the 1940s and have an exceptionally wide field of vision to be used to spot enemy aircraft. They're marked with DF, which stands for Doppelfernrohr and means double telescope. In their original and unrestored condition, they could be worth around £2,500.
What would you want for those, then?
Well, it's got to be £1,500.
I was at sort of £800.
Whoa. I think I'm right with my figures, and I think I'll stick with that.
Can we meet in the middle?
Make it £1,400, but that'd be my lowest. And that is my lowest.
Can't do 12.
No. Sorry.
OK. Yep. I'll check them.
Welcome.
Yep. Super. Really pleased with those. These, on this stand, in this condition, are up there in my sort of top 20 things to find. They really are. I'm over the moon with these. If you're a collector of anything, this is the condition you want things in. Used, but unrestored. This has never been touched. Today was really good. I came here to buy some neon signs, and I didn't buy any. That's what we're really here for. And that's the joy of this job, really, is you just never know what you're going to find.
Well, Drew and T have been here today. It's been really interesting. Obviously, he's got an eye for a good product. I'm delighted that the stuff carries on to a new location, really. I'm sure Drew will enjoy the binoculars for a while and pass them on.
John, thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Nice to see you too. All the best.
Nice to meet you. Cheers, bye.
Bye-bye.